Soldering for electronics. It is finally time to start doing stuff, and the first thing we're going to talk about is tinning your iron. You want to make sure if you have an on-off switch on your iron that it is set to on and that it is plugged into the wall. If you have a variable temperature, you're going to need to set it to the temperature that your solder recommends on the package, or if it's not there, take a look online. And then the other thing is the sponge. You want to make sure that it's damp, but not like sopping wet. So your soldering iron's been heating up in the holder. When it comes time to pick it up, you want to make sure you grab it by the grip up here. Make sure your fingers don't fall below this collar here because this is really hot. You can burn yourself. And don't forget, when it's time for you to put the soldering iron down, put it back in the holder. On to tinning your iron. And basically what this means is that you're going to apply a small amount of solder to the tip of your soldering iron. You're just going to like melt it right on there. If you have any excess, just wipe it off on the sponge. And it should generally look something like this when you're done with it. You want it to be clean and shiny, kind of like a newly sharpened pencil. So why are we doing this? Because I said so, that's why. The reason you want to tin the end of your soldering iron is to keep the temperature up so that when you go to solder, it's going to be way faster and way easier. And that's especially important if you have parts that are really sensitive to heat. You're going to want to do this every 3 or 4 solders, and you're also going to want to do this before you put it away. The reason is it's going to keep the tip of your soldering iron from oxidizing, and that's going to help keep it newer longer. If you're following along at home and you want to do some homework, practice. Practice tinning the end of your soldering iron, and then next week when we talk about stripping and tinning wires, it's going to be like super easy. So if you haven't yet, or you're new here and you want to catch up, here's the playlist. You can go and take a look at all the other videos. If this video is helpful, give it a thumbs up. And at the very least, if you want to join in with the soldering, subscribe, and we will see you in the next video. Okay, bye.